You might have heard about the Cold War in general, if in school or while searching for an history essay on the internet. Of course you wouldn't do something like that, right? Well, first of all, we assume that you know that it was a fight between the Soviet Union, which was communistic, and the USA, which was capitalistic, that there was almost no military confrontation between those two countries, and last but not least, that it can be divided into several hotspots, which leads us to the Korean War, one of these hotspots.
Now, some general facts about the Korean War. To that time, the President of the United States was Harry S. Truman, the leader of North Korea was Kim Il-sung, and the leader of South Korea was Syngman Rhee. 5 million people lost their lives, and USA spent $67 billion on the war, but the system of government didn't change.
Like you might know, Korea is split today. Here in this map you can see Korea. Well, okay, it's a map of North and South Korea. The division goes back to year 1945. So the time after Nazi Germany had been defeated, then was divided into four occupation zones, and in 1949 was divided again, but this time into East Germany, also known as GDR, the German Democratic Republic, and West Germany, also known as FRG, the Federal Republic of Germany. But to get back to Korea again, it was divided at the so-called 38th parallel, North Korea being communistic and South Korea being capitalistic, so two enemies separated by only an invisible border.
So, nothing to hold back, North Korean soldiers crossing the 38th parallel in June 1950. And after a short time, well, defined short, it was several months, Seoul falls to the communists. Every day North Korea gains more and more land, because South Korea wasn't strong enough to hold them back. Until US troops land in Incheon and fight back everything they have lost and even more, like you can see in this map of November 1950. In the end, China intervenes and stops South Korea from gaining more land, and the border got back to the 38th parallel. Well, at least almost. Like you can see, it was a real back and forth.
And of course, a war has good and bad effects on different countries. Here's an overview. The USA stopped communist expansion, Greece and Turkey joined NATO, and they upheld the Truman Doctrine, but were far too aggressive, which made the other countries nervous. The UN got first major success, but they could only win through violence. North Korea got a treaty with China, South Korea stayed capitalist, but many people died and there was no reunification. The Foreign War united China and improved rulers' prestige, but USSR relations became worse and they were banned from the UN Council. For the Soviet Union it was good that North Korea stayed communist and that they could test their air force against the US. But Chinese relations became worse and they lost a great deal of money.
But who actually won the war? Was it the communistic northern half or the capitalistic southern half? We think nobody won the war, because capitalism didn't spread and communism either. Nobody lost the war, because they didn't lose land or supporters.
This was everything about the Korean War.
We hope you understood everything and enjoyed watching.